Let's go.
Final instructions from Yuji Shimada. Gafurov says it'll be the same the first time they battle. He'll tap him out in the first round via rear naked choke. Nguyen's game plan. He said it's to stay on the outside. Stick and move. Look for the opportunities to exploit Gafurov when Gafurov wants to try and stamp his authority and leaves himself open, particularly to that overhand right.
He landed it early. Michael snuck it in. Gafurov looked at him, shook his head, and said, let's go.
Nguyen's corner believe that when Gafurov gets hit, he'll become frustrated. Oh, big right hand there from Gafurov and stuns Nguyen. And Nguyen ties him up. Gafurov trying to get him on the canvas. That's where he'll go to try and take Nguyen's back.
Immediately, Gafurov lands sort of an uppercut hook on that right side, sneaks it in, now has the body clinch. Let's see if Martin Nguyen can defend the takedown. Oh, but he muscles his way in. Oh no, Nguyen gives up his back, the body lock is on.
No, the figure four body lock, this is the beginning of the end, usually for opponents of Gafurov. Is it gonna be the undoing of Martin Nguyen once again? Gafurov going for the rear naked. The figure four body lock is locked on. Triangle, it'll suck the air out of Nguyen. It'll make it hard to breathe for the Australian.
Oh, what a big victory for Nguyen.
I can't believe he escaped it, Mitch. I've never seen that happen before.
He was right, he said it wouldn't happen, and he defends and gets back up to his feet.
Martin Nguyen, true to his word, he said Gafurov wouldn't be able to tap him out even if he had his back tonight.
Oh, what does that do to the mindset of Gafurov? Nobody's gotten out of that. Nobody's been able to get away from the possible rear naked choke, and Nguyen takes him down.
Yeah, it's a good question to ask, Mitch. Is there a dent in the psyche now of the champion, Marat Gafurov? And Nguyen's confidence has got to be oozing after escaping from something that nobody's escaped from a figure four body triangle rear naked choke attempt from Marat Gafurov.
Gafurov's breathing kind of heavy. He needs to settle down, relax. Realize that's what happens at this the highest level of martial arts.
Remember, Gafurov guaranteed the rear naked choke again. He guaranteed it in the first round. He said, sign the pink slips, sign the ownership papers. It's gonna happen again. Nguyen showing patience now. Left hand from the Australian. The Aussie threaded it well, picking his shots.
Gafurov lands a left hand of his own.
Beautiful. Right hand over the top there from Martin Nguyen.
That overhand is landing over and over again on Gafurov. He attacks the lower part of the leg. I like that attack.
Gafurov not flailing in wildly. Good sticky jab once more from Nguyen. Gafurov throws up a front kick, a little lazy on the execution, however. Nguyen with the overhand right, he curls that overhand right with power like Mitchell Stark bowling pace for the Australian cricket team. Roundhouse kick there from Gafurov. Gafurov hopes for a takedown, puts Nguyen on his back, but Nguyen locks up the head, locks up the neck. What can Martin Nguyen do from here?
He's got an arm in guillotine, but it's tough to finish the BJJ black belt Gafurov.
Gafurov will want to try and posture up. He wants to try and pass to the side of the body. Goes to half guard, goes to side control. Knee from Gafurov.
Nice. Nguyen's, oh, very good by Nguyen to get back into half guard. Gafurov had side control. He's going to try to lace that leg through. Get up on top, but good ground skills shown by Nguyen.
What an amazing matchup we're seeing in the first round here. Set for five, a brilliant contest for the World Featherweight Championship.
We're 1 minute away from one streak being ended. Martin Nguyen's four first round finishes, but we still got four more rounds to see Gafurov's streak extended.
Gafurov, former world pancration champion. Pancration as a sport dates to ancient Greece. And there's a knee to the jaw from Gafurov. Now to side control. Very aggressive knee on belly position for the Russian.
Cuts through that guard like a hot knife through butter. Tries to go knee on belly. He wants Nguyen to turn. He wants him to give it up. Oh, and he gets away again.
Nguyen does his finest Houdini impersonation and escapes from Marat Gafurov.
That's two.
Glad glances towards Fari Selyevski in his corner, gives him a nod, says, I'm okay, boss.
Look at the grind from Gafurov to drag the fight back down to the ground. Tries to lock up the legs. Oh, he delivers a knee on the exit.
Nguyen does a quick count of his teeth after the knee. And that's how the first round ends. And what an amazing opening round to the Featherweight Championship of the World.
Nice change of stances there from Nguyen to give Gafurov a different look. There he is throwing that big right hook. But Gafurov slid out the way, threw a counter of his own, dropped Nguyen. But here was the escapes from the rear naked choke to save Nguyen and continue the fight. There's a nice little exchange there. Gafurov marching forward, throwing the heavy hands. Rich Franklin, how did you score that exciting first round?
Well, the graphic here shows you the score I have on the ground control. I have Gafurov ahead on the ground because he was landing the takedowns, and every time they ended up in a position, they were able to scramble, but still Gafurov was taking his back, attacking with chokes, landing strikes. I also have him slightly edging out the striking superiority category because he dropped Nguyen one time, rocked him a couple more times, although the edge in the striking superiority category is much lower. This is still a very close fight.
Second round set for five in front of a sellout crowd inside Stadium Nagara. And one championship, Kuala Lumpur, quest for greatness. Wherever you're watching in 128 countries around the world, you've got to be on the edge of your seat. And one championship needed to have only sold the edge of the seats here inside of Stadium Nagara, because everyone is on the edge of their seats. Southpaw to orthodox, switching stance for Martin Nguyen. Gafurov fires a roundhouse kick. Nguyen catches it on the forearm. Switching stance again, the Australian Vietnamese martial artist.
Gafurov pushing forward. He likes to throw big, flashy kicks because he's not scared to go to the ground. But that's exactly what he wants. He wants to take this fight to the ground, control and dominate his opponents.
Gafurov does a great job of curling these knees to the orbital. Looks to take the back here at Martin Nguyen. He's going to try and climb him and slap a rear naked choke that way. To no avail, Nguyen defends again. And now the corking knees from the Aussie.
True to his word so far, his defense in the grappling area has been stellar against that rear naked choke, Michael.
Nguyen shrugs him off. The chin a little high here on Gafurov. Now he puts the hands up. Can Nguyen capitalize? Maybe the jab to the overhand right. It's a bread and butter combination for the Aussie. And there it is!
China against Australia.
Ladies and gentlemen, this next...
Back of the head and spine. As you know, no foot stomp to the head. Don't grab the fence. Follow my command all the time. Defend yourself for all the time. Touch glove if you want. Back your corner.
This fight is brought to you by City of Dreams, world-class destination.
Judge, time, ready?
Both men tattooed across the chest and down one arm. That could be where the similarities end. Look at the low stance that Nguyen has. Ready to spring into action. That's a very unorthodox beginning. I haven't seen that from him before. Takes a kick to the leg and a right hand from the Chinese fighter.
Martin Nguyen knows he has the advantage here on the ground, but Li Kai Nguyen has been working so hard. Nice little stuff there. Martin Nguyen went in for the takedown. A big belly to back suplex there by Li Kai Nguyen as he spins, but gives up his back there as he attempts his the back elbow.
It's a very fast paced start from Lee.
Don't grab the fingers, don't grab the gloves.
Yeah, Li Kai Nguyen's got big takedowns. He likes those suplexes. Little exchange, will show respect there.
Big bolo right hand, overhand right, like a fast bowler from his home country of Australia. Tried it again, that right hand comes from a way back and he delivers it quickly, just as Lee was coming in. I'll be wary of that next time he jumps into the attack. Nice,
shot.
Started off with a knee. The punches came in and then he goes for the takedown, but Nguyen defends it well.
What a furious exchange by Li Kai Wen.
Oh, it all started up from Nguyen.
As he superb single punch.
Big body kick, but Nguyen answers right back with a right hand of his own.
And the uppercut again. What a rocking blow that is. The right hand from Nguyen this time as the counter. And that is the fearsome weapon for the Australian. No question so far. Oh.
Both these fighters have been saying all week how they want to apply pressure and just come forward, and they're both just slamming into each other.
And Nguyen goes down. Tremendous punch from the Chinese man. They are so well matched, these two. What an entertaining brawl.
What a chin on Martin Nguyen to take that shot.
Second time he showed a great deal of resilience to these hard punches.
That punch echoed around the stadium as Li Kai Wen attempts to go for a Kimura, possibly. He's got kind of a chicken wing there. Just kind of soften him up, Nguyen, with the big body shots there, just thumping on Li Kai Wen's body. Yeah, he can use this time now to just recover. If he was hurt from that big punch by Li Kai Wen, Nguyen can just sort of gain his composure and just recover fully if he is hurt.
Li is bleeding from the nose, no doubt from some of the tremendous punching exchanges that these two have got themselves involved in.
Yeah, I think it was that first uppercut, Steve.
Yeah, will often do damage to a nose and uppercut.
Both these fighters are showing a huge heart and big chin to take shots like that.
We've seen some tremendous punching. Two super uppercuts from Nguyen and a sparkling left hook from Li. Will Li be taking a breather on the deck here, Mitch, or is this just as hard work, only slightly different?
Man, after that shot.
Oh, the kick to the head. Technical ground kick, number two comes in. Number three. Oh, and the left hand there.
Big left hand.
Clean, and another one. And Li's in trouble.
Oh, now he's jumping all over it. Looks like the break is over, and the rear naked choke is sunk in. He doesn't have the hooks in, so the leverage isn't there, but he can still finish from this. He chooses to let it go and just kind of control the back. He's got to work on that position before he attempts the submission. This is an amazing 4 minutes of action here.
The good news is there's still 50 seconds to go in this round if it goes that far, and we've got 2 5-minute rounds after this. It's a great contest.
You can see now he's got one hook in, and he's just choosing to do damage as he slides that second hook in. Now he's in a really good position to unload.
6 right hand punches in a row coming through. Nguyen on top.
Oh, he's
literally
flattened out. And Nguyen is unloading on him.
Olivier Coste is looking closely.
Li Kai Wen has got a move. He's got
it. The punches that's came in unanswered. It. Martin Nguyen extends his record to 6-1, 3-1 in the ONE Championship cage. And Li Kai Wen has impressed us so well. Finds himself on the losing end in this organization for the very first time. What a fight and what a win. Li Kai went with the takedown there, but we saw some tremendous punches. Rich Franklin is alongside me as Mitch Chilson goes into the cage to get an interview with our winner. That was entertaining stuff, Rich.
Well, you know what? I'm so glad that that didn't go to the round break, because I didn't want to have to actually score that. I mean, like, Li Kai Wen took control early, did a bunch of damage, and then, you know, Martin just comes back after he gets dropped and then just does a tremendous amount of damage on the ground, with especially that right hand that landed at the end. And I just, once he sunk in that sub, I'm like, if he doesn't get this, it's a near submission. And it's basically a dead even fight at this point in time.
So you're off the hook judging wise. That's great news. But this is mixed martial arts in the true sense of the phrase. I mean, we saw takedown.
11 years, the Japanese man, the older fighter. They are identical in terms of height.
When we break down their strikes, or there's, we see a slight edge is going to go to Martin Nguyen. Grappling, they're very close, but cage control goes to Yokota.
Ladies and gentlemen, this next fight is three rounds of 5 minutes in a one championship featherweight bout and is brought to you by Burger King. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, he is a brace featherweight champion standing at 173 centimeters tall, holding a professional MMA record of 7 wins and 1 loss. Representing KMA Top Team and fighting out of Sydney, Australia, put your hands together for Martin, the Situation Nguyen. And now, introducing his opponent, fighting out of the red corner. This man is a deep featherweight champion, standing at 173 centimeters tall, holding a professional MMA record of 25 wins, 6 losses, and 3 draws. Fighting out of Chiba, Japan, he is Katsunori Yokota! And when the action begins, your referee in charge, Mr. Olivier Coste.
Low blow, back of the head and spine. This is my corner turn. Defend yourself at all time. Touch grab if you want. And back your corner.
Olivier Coste overseeing this one. Yokota against Nguyen is brought to you by Burger King. 3 5-minute rounds. Judges score the contest right, in its entirety. Judge, not time. Stanza Ready? By stanza. Ready? This Fight. One should be a good one. A very distinct possibility of a title challenge sometime in 2017 for the winner. Big prize on offer. Some might say a whopper.
Both fighters want nothing more than to get back to that title shot. And that was a Burger King reference there from Steve Dawson. But we're seeing a nice relaxed style from Yokota. His nickname is Hage Haya, which means fast baldy.
Which is fantastic, isn't it?
By
a great nickname.
Teammates. But we could have a battle of the best nicknames here between the Situation, Martin Nguyen, and Fast Baldy.
I've got to give it to Fast Baldy, I'm afraid. But Nguyen has an awful lot to offer above and beyond nicknames here. In comes that flying teep kick from Yokota. And Nguyen was alert enough to back away from that and the follow-up punches. You can see he's cocking that right leg, Yokota, all the time, just looking to do something with it.
Nguyen has told me that he wants to be a little bit more patient in this fight. He's usually, he kind of lets emotions take over and he rushes in and he makes a little bit of mistakes sometimes. So he wants to be a little more patient and he really wants to be relaxed and composed in at least the first round of this fight.
Just as Yokota came in, Nguyen's overhand right looked to land. Caught quite a bit of glove, I think. That's how focused he is and how sharp the 27-year-old is.
We saw some of previous Nguyen's fights. He's got a big overhand right. And you can see the way Yokota is kind of inching his chin out there. He's not really keeping his chin tucked. And he just got caught right there by a right hand. So he's got to keep that chin a little bit down because Nguyen's got a powerful right hand.
He's throwing it, he's faking it. It's gonna be the dominant weapon in these early moments anyway. There it is again, countering the left jab. It came over the top of the jab. And Yokota will have had a good view of that already. Let's see what he's gonna do about it. The way Nguyen beat Christian Lee, who had such a lot of attention and deservedly so, it was something of a destruction and really raised his profile at the back end of a very, very substantial 14 months for this Australian fighter. The Situation.
Action!
See how composed and relaxed Yokota is. He's threatening that foot. He's really kind of lifting that back leg up to sort of threaten that rear leg push kick.
That overhand right is genuinely overhand, isn't it? The elbow is actually higher than the glove when it lands.
Yeah, Martin Nguyen throws a beautiful right hand, like he's throwing a baseball almost with that right hand, but And the way Yokota's got his hands down and his chin out, that's like, it plays perfectly into that weapon of Nguyen's. Lots of feints, though, coming from Yokota.
Yeah, there are a lot.
So as you can see, it's kind of affected Martin. Like, he doesn't really know exactly what's coming from Yokota.
He wants that right leg, doesn't he, to... Oh, there's a big overhand right counterpunch. And he's certainly hurt. And Olivier Goss jumps in. And Martin Nguyen has done it again. And this is another enormous scalp for the Australian. And it can't be very long before we see him in a rematch.
No one would say that Martin Nguyen isn't a young man, but he's 9 years older than his opponent tonight. Nguyen against Lee, brought to you by Fairtex. Be inspired.
Just time, ready, fight!
Watch out for the fast start from Christian Lee. It's very much his signature, he doesn't hang about.
Changing stance by Christian Lee. He's actually slowed down quite a bit. He's kind of understanding composure and how to be relaxed, but he can explode at any minute.
Oh,
and
a right hand
landed by Martin Nguyen.
Really cuffed him, didn't he? Got a clean shot in there. By far the biggest step up for Christian Lee is what Martin Nguyen represents. And Christian got back in with a left hand there that also caught his opponent fairly cleanly. So a good punch each from these men in the opening seconds.
That overhand right is real dangerous from Nguyen because Christian kind of keeps his posture really high and his head looks like it's really elevated, so he doesn't kind of tuck the chin in. So he's susceptible to that overhand right from Martin Nguyen.
It's Lee very much in pursuit mode, as we thought it might be.
Nice catch there on the kick, spins around, takes control, and this is where Martin Nguyen wants to get this fight. He wants to make it dirty, wants to make it gritty, and he likes to drag these fights down to the ground. Trying to single leg big takedown, but Christian pops right back up.
He did so well to land on his feet there. Looked for a moment as if he'd be landing on his head.
Very
athleticism
agile.
And flexibility, agility, that's right, exactly the word we were looking for.
There's another one of those big right hands coming from Nguyen, but Christian ducks under it. We have ourselves a fight, folks.
What an arc to that uppercut from Nguyen, which I'm not sure that it connected, but sent out a message, didn't it?
When I saw this fight on the card, I knew that this one could be the Fun 88 fight of the night.
What a decent overhand right that was from Nguyen as Lee came in.
He's throwing out a stiff jab there. He's got an awkward guard. You know, he keeps a very wide guard, very wide stance. Not your typical boxing stance or Muay Thai stance.
Good left jab from Lee there, but it's that counter overhand right from Nguyen that he's got to be careful of when he throws that jab.
Nice. I like how he threw that overhand right, stepped forward with the right foot, and then came with a left overhand.
Lee's been quite adept just in the last 20 seconds of getting counter-right. But he caught that one. Went down and bounced straight back up again.
That's it, man. Christian's got to get his chin down. His head's really high in the air. And Nguyen is taking advantage of that with these big overhands.
Can't take your eyes off this one for a second. Good ramrod left jab from Christian Lee.
Now Christian's starting to get a little bit more compact in his stance. Again, another overhand right,
kick.
Steve.
Yeah, he threw the kick and was exposed to the right hand, wasn't he? These counters from Nguyen are expert punches.
Will we see Christian Lee in the second round? And that's the question on everybody's mind.
The energy, the sharpness of youth, very apparent from Lee, but you can just see that little bit more seniority from Nguyen. A little bit more cleanliness to his work.
Well, he's timing these overhands perfectly. Christian's got to keep that chin tucked. Not let him get caught by one of these big overhand rights, or lefts for that matter.
Christian Lee hasn't seen an opponent like this in the ONE Championship game, so that's a good right hand. And it's set Nguyen stumbling it, and Nguyen's in trouble.
And Lee just wobbles
up. Oh, Nguyen pounces on this. This could be his opportunity. Gets in close, that head is exposed to possible knees. Lee bounces back up, but he goes back down again. He's certainly shaken up.
Christian's hurt, Steve. Christian's hurt.
Left.
Big big left hook landed by Nguyen started this onslaught, and Nguyen is jumping all over it.
Could already be the Fun 88 fight of the night, this one. You just cannot take your eyes off it.
He's kind of got him in a guillotine here, sort of a modified choke.
Oh, it looks very clean as well.
He's kind of lacing his hand around
under
his
the chin. I'm not sure how he's getting through this.
Christian's fighting, he might be out.
I think he's out. I think he